GoodNotes 6 is amazing. It has been my go-to note-taking app for the iPad, but with its latest update, it's aiming to be the most complete note-taking app on the market. But the real question is, does it truly live up to the hype? So don't miss this video, as today we are taking a deep dive into its features, and you'll be surprised to see how much you can get done using this app. My name is Prithviraj, and I create videos on productivity, tech, and life. GoodNotes has always been a top-tier note-taking app, and with its 6th iteration, it's obvious they have worked hard to maintain their legacy while pushing the boundaries of what's possible in a digital notebook. With the GoodNotes 6 update, the app introduces some game-changing features, and to top it off, they have even introduced some AI features to help us improve our overall note-taking experience. But as much as I love GoodNotes 6, it's not perfect, but we will be discussing all the drawbacks at the end. But before that, let's skip to the good part. First things first, let us talk about the look and feel of this app. If you have previously used GoodNotes 5, you'll recognize the layout, but they have definitely made some major upgrades. The app still uses a clean folder-based system, which I really like, as it makes it super easy to organize our notes. But what's new? We now have way more customization options for our notebooks. When we tap on the plus icon, we get a list of options we can choose from. We can create an entire notebook, or even we can create a quick note if you just wanted to note something down quickly. This is a great addition, as we can jot things down straight away without having to go through a thousands of page options. This is surely gonna reduce the friction of creating a new note. But if you wanted to truly customize your experience, we can pick from different sorts of cover designs. I really like this checkbox cover design that they have added. And as usual, we can choose from different page layouts and page colors as well. We can choose from lined papers to planners, and even some really cool creative templates. Like, we have templates for creating task lists as well as monthly planners. It makes your notes feel more personal, and who doesn't love that? And once we're inside, the toolbar has been cleaned up as well. You have got all your writing tools like pen, highlighter, eraser, and everything right in front of you. In the pen options tab, we can choose from different pen types like fountain pen, ball pen, and of course the brush pen. And to top it off, we can adjust the pressure sensitivity as per our liking. And beside those, we still have the quick toggles to quickly choose between different pen sizes as well as different pen colors. Now, this is something unique. GoodNotes have recently added this tape tool, and this thing is quite interesting, I have to say. It's basically like those masking tapes. You can use the tape tool while revising your notes. For example, let's take this diagram of a human heart. I use the tape tool to hide all of the content. Now, while I'm revising, I can simply tap on that, and that will add or remove the tape. This can come in really useful while memorizing important keywords and also while revising your notes. Personally, there is one feature that I absolutely love about GoodNotes 6, and that is the fact that you can simply erase stuff just by scribbling on that. You won't have to keep switching to your eraser tool again and again and again. You can simply strike it off when you make a mistake while writing, and it will get rid of that for you. This will give you a more natural feel and also help you speed up your note-taking process. And most importantly, it's super satisfying. I can literally do this all day. One of the most powerful features inside of GoodNotes 6 is its lasso tool, or the selection tool, whatever you want to call it. And the thing is that we don't even have to select the lasso tool. We can now simply circle our text, and when we long press on it, it will automatically create a selection for us. This is a super clean addition. We can simply resize or adjust the positions after making a selection, or even change its color. And when we long press on it, we can convert our handwriting into text. This feature has come a long way. GoodNotes 6 now has a better handwriting to text conversion, and trust me, it works way better than before. Even when I write super quickly and messy, which happens more than I would like to admit, but yeah, it converts my scribbles into readable text. Just select your handwritten note, hit on convert, and boom, you're done. If you're a math student, we also get an option to convert it as a mathematical equation. We have a dedicated option for that. The new spell check feature also fixes your spelling mistake, that too, in your own handwriting. Just take a look. I made this spelling mistake, and I can simply tap on it, and it will try to mimic my ugly handwriting and try to fix it. This feature is more like a hit or miss, but with time, I believe this can really turn into something amazing. And also, we are very close to hitting 100k subs on this channel. I would really appreciate if you could consider hitting that subscribe button. It would definitely help me out a lot. As we all know, AI is the buzzword these days. GoodNotes have added a few AI assisted features. The handwriting recognition and the spell check features are some of them, but we also have this chat box inside. Think of this like ChatGPT right inside of GoodNotes. You can ask a question just like you normally would in ChatGPT, or you can use it to brainstorm ideas when you jot down some key points. Also, you can summarize your notes using that. Say you have just attended a lecture and you have taken a ton of messy notes during the meeting. You don't have to waste hours looking for the key points. GoodNotes AI can scan through your content and generate a concise summary for you. This can be a lifesaver for students who are preparing for their exams. Another big addition has to be the text block. We now have a dedicated segment to take text-based notes. The interface will feel very familiar to that of MS Word or Google Docs, and we of course have all the essential tools required. Along with that, we also have a dedicated tab to record voice notes as well. Earlier, this feature was missing, but I'm glad they added this feature in GoodNotes 6 update. But they did one better. It will do a live transcription of your voice notes, and this thing is a total game changer. For lazy people like me, you can now simply open your voice recording tab and start dictating your notes, and it's gonna transcribe it for you real time. time. Super helpful this is. And as per organization goes, you can really micromanage your notes into various folders and subfolders. We can now customize our folders as per our liking. We can change the colors of our folders and also choose from different folder icons that we have. This will really help us in easy identification of our folders, also while adding a bit of personal touch. And we of course can import PDFs inside this app. You can load up your PDFs of your textbooks and documents. Hence, you'll be able to take book notes or annotate PDFs directly inside this app. The search feature here is also super smart. You can simply search up what you need and it will find through all the PDFs, handwritten text and notes, that too in a flash. Now let's get into the real stuff. How does GoodNotes 6 perform when it comes to taking notes? The writing experience is hands down one of the best parts of GoodNotes 6. Everything feels really smooth and natural. I have been using my iPad Air M2 with the Apple Pencil Pro throughout this video. The pen tool along with the Apple Pencil Pro feels super smooth and the pressure sensitivity is spot on. Hence everything is gonna feel super natural whether you're drawing or writing. I did try out GoodNotes with some third-party styluses out there because we all know Apple Pencils are kind of pricey. My experience with an universal stylus was a bit iffy, I must say. Like sometimes it was getting the job done for me, but the other times it just wouldn't detect my stylus. But if you're serious about digital note taking, then I recommend please save up for the Apple Pencil. The writing experience using the Apple Pencil is simply unmatched. I face near zero latency using the Apple Pencil Pro while writing here on GoodNotes 6. The highlighter tool is just as smooth and it even snaps to text or lines, making it awesome for annotating PDFs. Many apps actually struggle in the palm rejection aspect, but it was perfect over here on GoodNotes. It won't accidentally scroll or make lines because of your palm touching on the screen. We can also adjust the palm rejection sensitivity from the settings, but all in all, I face no issues as far as the writing is concerned. You're gonna have a great time taking handwritten notes on this app. Alright, let's talk about one of the most exciting additions of GoodNotes 6, and that is the GoodNotes Marketplace. So what is this GoodNotes Marketplace? Think of this as an in-app app store where you can browse and download a massive variety of templates, covers, and stickers, or even pre-made planners. Whether you're a student or a professional, there's something here for everyone. Who says note-taking has to be boring? You can personalize your notebooks with beautiful covers that suit your vibe. It's a small little detail, but it adds so much personality in your digital notes. Also, if you're into planners, then you can also check out my daily planner template that I made myself. I'll be leaving its link in the description box below the like button in case you're interested in that. As much as I love GoodNotes 6, it's not at all perfect. Let's talk about some of the drawbacks. First things first, let us discuss the pricing. GoodNotes 6 has switched to a subscription-based model, which is a bit of a bummer. We do have a one-time payment option for GoodNotes, but there is a bit of a catch. If you buy GoodNotes using the one-time payment option, you will only be able to access GoodNotes on the Apple ecosystem. As in, you can access your notes on your iPhone as well as on your MacBook as it syncs via iCloud. But in case you have an Android device or a Windows PC, you won't be able to access them at all. Hence, in case you have an Android or a Windows device, you will have to get the subscription plan. Here is a screenshot of all the payment plans of GoodNotes 6. You can clearly see that all platforms are not included in the one-time payment option. Here's a screenshot of the payment plans in Indian rupees as well. Even if I ignore the pricing, the Android version of GoodNotes really sucks. It's not even a native app for Android. It's running via the web as of today. So if you're not on the Apple ecosystem, you might want to consider looking elsewhere, as the Android version would really disappoint you. Many features are missing and the overall experience is very buggy. Also, another drawback of GoodNotes is that it often starts to lag while working with large notebooks. This one will come down to the power of your device. I've been using it on my iPad Air M2, hence I didn't really face any issues in that aspect, as the M2 chipset is powerful enough to handle everything you throw at it. So is GoodNotes 6 worth it? Absolutely. If you're on the Apple ecosystem and looking for a powerful, flexible note-taking app, then this one is a no-brainer. But if you're not into subscriptions and need something that works across different platforms, you might want to take a look at different alternatives. Speaking of that, let me suggest an alternative for you. You can check out this app called Notewise. It's very similar to GoodNotes and also offers a ton of powerful features. And the best of all, it's available both on Android as well as iOS. Click here on this video and over there we have discussed about Notewise in more details. See you there.